The PSA World Series final between Rami Ashour of Egypt serving, Mohamed El Shabaghi of Egypt receiving. Best of five games. Love all.
So Rami Ashour kicking off this final at the Power Courts and Courts at PSA World Series squash finals 2013. And it is localised between the Battle of the Cities. You've got Ashour from Cairo and El Shabaghi from the sea town of Alexandria.
One all.
Serious in-house rivalry here, Flash Gordon.
It sure is, Joey. There is a lot of local bragging rights on display here tonight.
Two one.
I think an interesting thing here early on, Joey, will be to see the strategy that Mohamed El Shabaghi tries to produce here in the early going. Last night against Nick Matthew, he played a very conventional, traditional game up and down the side walls, drawing the Englishman into protracted rallies and wearing him down. Obviously, Rami Ashour is going to be a lot more adventurous with his shot selection. So the question is, will Shabaghi try and neutralize with straight play, or will he try and out-attack Rami Ashour?
Well, the ball just going into the backstand. Hopefully it'll get returned. Don't want to waste time warming up another ball, because it will take forever on this court. Well, obviously somebody in the stands not being very honest. Flash, probably pocketing the ball. Well, if it's gone down behind, a fresh ball. So this is going to take time to warm up. Look how dead that ball is. Unbelievable. Even with the power of these guys hitting, it's going to take some time to get that warm flush.
No, absolutely, Joey. It's very chilly on there.
Well, if you are going to warm the ball up, you might as well do it like this. This is ridiculous.
Well, especially with Mohamed El Shabaghi, he's well in front of that tee line.
Yeah, he is. He's not wasting around. Well, that was pretty quick, I have to say. That was pretty much the world record for ball warming. So El Shabaghi serving at 3-2. Fresh new ball hit.
Hand out, 3-all.
I really feel it's imperative for El Shabaghi to win this first game.
No, absolutely. That's definitely, I conclude with that, Joey, because Rami Ashour seemed to grow in confidence so much last night, and I could see the same thing happening tonight. We see in his movements, he seems very sprightly and energized for this.
And it's interesting, and this shows the quality of Ashour, how he reads the game.
Three.
Mohamed El Shabaghi has that shot, which is a fake at the front right-hand corner where he cuts down very late into a drop shot, shows the drive, and he fooled Ashour in the first group stage with it a few times, but Ashour read it straight away. Certainly a better start. Oh, look at that length from Rami Ashour.
Down.
Oh, it's good severe hitting from El Shabaghi. Things starting to warm up quite quickly in this first game.
4-all.
Well, I think something that needs to be noted is right from the beginning here, Rami Ashour has really pushed up the court and is trying to take the ball exceedingly early and take time away from Mohamed El Shabaghi and not give him that time he needs to wind up and really crack the ball
and
at that pace he plays at.
5-4.
one of the most patient starts I've seen from Ramy Ashour for a long, long time. It's going to be a stroke.
Stroke to Ashour.
Good patient play from the elder Egyptian.
Left side, left.
Opens up a 2-point cushion at 6-4.
6-4.
Well, and that's pretty awesome. The angle presented itself. El Shabagi sometimes cuts it through his legs. This time going for the more orthodox drop shot.
It's been very fertile early on here, Ramy Ashour, in that backhand front corner, reading the ball across the middle quite early.
He always does flash. That's part of his game. It's his main game. Cutting that second ball. First one isn't an outright winner. He's so quick to read if it's a cross court or a straight drive from the front. Good tempo here. Subtly mixing the paces. Sure.
Yes, lad.
Oh, that's going to be a professional let. It was good width, but El Shabagi not really wanting to. Well, he'd only be able to play a boast, hence stopping slightly, manufacturing the rules there. So streetwise, Mohamed El Shabagi saw that last night against Nick Matthew.
6-all.
He's done well. He's drawn level. So he's not letting Ashour get away at all.
And it's interesting to note, Joey, Ramy Ashour hasn't particularly started very slowly tonight.
Not at all. And there's the unforced error off the service.
7-6.
Terrific win there from Ashour. Such an effective shot on this very cold glass court. Twice it bounces before the sidewall. Stroke.
Yes, let. 7-all.
And that's worth a review.
You guys, the ball short.
Let, room to play.
If I went through, I wouldn't see the ball because it's standing right in front of me.
Seven all left. Are you accepting the decision? 7-all left.
Very good question.
Left, left, left.
Side box. It's right. Right box. Right.
Yep, 7-all.
Surprised he didn't review that at 7-all.
Yeah,
very,
no.
Very strange. I mean, Yuji reviews at love all in the first. Well, he's been rewarded by a poor shot from El Shabagi, but that was definitely a stroke, I feel.
Yeah, I think so as well. It was loose ball coming straight into the middle. Shabagi not making a tremendous amount of effort to clear.
Down.
That was on his racket all day long there. Poor error. There goes the talking to himself. Very interesting with his movement. He's when he goes into the front corner and he's lobbing, he's just nicely stabilizing. He's not trying to rip out of that movement. I think that's something he's been working on with Thierry Linkou a little bit. He started to do it towards the end against Gaultier. He's not trying to recall quickly, which is the area that causes a problem with the hamstring. Because he's so skillful, he's able to actually pause a little bit more in that front corner flush.
No, absolutely, and I think this slight change in movements benefiting him. He seems a lot more relaxed and fluid in his movements.
That was very interesting because El Shabagi elected to play, which was the right shot. Because he was out of position. I mean, he would have struggled to get that boast. He was so far back, unfortunately, catching the top of the tin. So both these players making unforced errors in the business end of this first.
Yes, lad. 9-8.
Yeah, no, I think this was a steady let, Joey.
Oh, for sure.
In some ways, he was quite lucky to get a let there.
Yeah, could have been a no-let.
Ball was traveling very quickly.
It was. Shabagi was clearing. It's a good shot.
Yes, lad. 9-8.
Doesn't want to review, does he? It's strange. Sometimes he forgets that actually the video review exists, you know. I'm sure of it.
Yes, lad. 9-8.
Review.
Whoa, there
video
we go.
Review
on call.
On the yes, lad decision.
He's going for a review on this one. Flesh, talk us through it.
The ball is in the middle of the court.
Well, Rami helping me out with the description, saying the ball is in the middle of the court. Shabagi playing a very loose straight drive back at himself. Rami wanting to swing at that ball. I kind of feel like this will stay as a let, though, because it still is a little bit away from Rami. There was still a bit of movement in before he would have been able to play that ball.
Yes, let decision upheld.
Well, the decision stands.
No reviews remaining.
So Rami Ashour losing his review.
Yes, lad. 9-8.
Well, a few decisions at the crucial stage. It's a terrific pressure from Ashour. He's leaping on every volley. El Shabagi actually struggling to get in front of him.
Well, it really is way up the court from Ashour, and he's hitting with great authority.
Oh, that's brilliant. That is a wonderful bit of pressure from Ashour, and that's more like it. I'd love to see him play more like this on a regular basis. Everything was going to the back of the court, and he was able to win the rally at the back of the court. Two game balls for Ashour. Oh, that is quite well played. He really did pop that into the net there. It was a weak lob.
9-10.
See, game clever one. Shot by El Shabagi, taking the pace off it beautifully. So still not over. One game ball opportunity left for Ashour. Well, there's the big forehand. So two forehand volleys.
Well, it really has been a tremendous effort from El Shabagi here in the latter stages. He's really buckled down and not allowed Ashour to run away with this game.
Far from it.
Each player has one review available.
We're into an exciting tiebreak in this first. Absolutely nothing between them.
And if El Shabagi manages to win this game, it could be a real momentum shifter because Rami Ashour has been the more positive of the two for much of this first game.
Yes, lad. 10-0. Yes, lad.
No,
it's going to go for a review.
He was putting his
video
with
you, Ashour, on the yes let decision.
He was not looking for the ball here.
Let's have a look at this one. Was he shaping a bit too much for looking for his opponent? So it's a loose ball by El Shabagi. I think that's a stroke. He is exaggerating his swing slightly, but can't really hit this ball. El Shabagi's... No, that's a stroke, I feel. What about you, Flush?
Yeah, I think I'm going to go with you on this one, Joey. I mean, he is slightly looking for El Shabagi, but just look how bent his elbow is. He's not taking an extreme amount of space.
Yes, decision upheld. Ashour has no reviews remaining. 10-0.
Well, there you go, Joey. Obviously, we didn't quite see that the referees were.
Okay. Yes, lad. 10-0.
Well, he goes for his cross-court, Nick. And interestingly, with this shot, he doesn't look to hit it as hard. He actually takes the pace off it, so it didn't find the Nick outright. But because he didn't hit it 100 miles an hour, it stayed short. Third game ball for a short. Boy, he looked to shape up again there. And that is very, very tight.
And out, 11-all.
Been some great responses here from El Shabagi, not allowing Ashour to take this game.
Not at all. He's come back with such quality, El Shabagi. And if this game starts to become a bit frenetic, I feel that really does suit El Shabagi. He's able to really draw on adrenaline. Up to 18 minutes. Down. Oh, he makes the error. He had El Shabagi breathing down his neck. It was loose. He had him shut out. See
12
this?
11.
Oh, and he hits game the top ball of the tin, willing it to go over. El Shabagi looked like he was going to do a Superman dive to try and get that one back. And he's got first game ball opportunity. El Shabagi, will he convert first time? That would be a massive blow, Flush, to Rami Ashour.
Really has been an impressive mental effort here from El Shabagi, because he's just weathered the Ashour storm. He's been
12-11.
Slightly behind Rami Ashour for much game of this ball game, but he's just bided his time, and waited for the loose balls that he can finally attack.
Going to be a no
lead.
No, way, way too good.
Hand out.
Didn't make an error on that one, Ashour. Getting really taking a massive bit of impact as well. Brilliant bit of impact. Managed to keep his balance and put the shot in. 12 all. This is such high quality.
12 all.
Such a big forehand, possibly one of the biggest forehands in the game, El Shabagi. Huge wingspan. Oh, he's got it. I don't know how he's got it. And he's back on his feet. That's ridiculous. Flash Gordon's got his microphone in his mouth.
Oh, it's just incredible, Joey. And not only has he gotten all these back, but he's returning it with interest. Just the quality here is astounding.
Oh, that's an awesome rally! Absolutely awesome! That's woken up the crowd here in Westwood. Well, Flash, I managed to dig that now.
Well, Joey, I'm
say something, Flash, say something.
Well, I was speechless there for a few minutes because that was just unbelievable. The quality of that rally and the amount of dynamic movement that was going on was really unbelievable.
And there is the fist pump, and rightly so, and a thumbs up as well. I love the thumbs up. Gregory Gaultier usually likes the best opponent, but Ramya Shaw will give the thumbs
game
up.
Ball.
Another game ball for Shaw in this tiebreak. Finally got some electricity in the atmosphere in this tournament. This game.
Hand out.
And he plays it superbly well. He will not go away, El Shabagi. 22 minutes. It goes to show when you have people that are very, very extensive at the front of the court, these guys are playing the basics with all their quirks quite brilliantly.
Well, the hitting's really picked up, Joey. They're really knocking the ball around at a ferocious speed.
They are, but with great accuracy, particularly to the back. You can see this tight work down that camera angle. I mean, the more we go down this side, the popular commentator on Squash TV, Paul Johnson, will be very happy. Oh, that's too good. That's too good. Played from trademark short take back, in fact, no take back. We see the replay here.
Hand out.
Plays
14,
it in front of
13.
Himself. He hardly takes the swing ball. Back. Uses all his fingers to cut the ball into the front left hand corner.
Down.
Stepped up there. El Shabagi read this. We look at the replay on this one.
Hand out.
He's come across before he's hit that.
All.
He knew he was going for that cross-court drive. And El Shabagi all over it.
Well, this is the amazing thing with this first game, Joey. Every time it looks like Ramya Shaw is on the cusp of taking it, El Shabagi comes up absolutely
down.
Huge.
Well, he's rewarded. He is rewarded with an unforced error. So this is the second
15,
opportunity
14.
For El Shabagi. And
game
I have to
ball.
Say, with the 94 minutes he played yesterday with Matthew at a quite unnerving pace, tactically this is quite brilliant for Ramya Shaw because we're up to nearly 25 minutes for this first game alone.
Shrabagi's really pushed on the court. He's taking a lot of initiative here.
He's hit him. This is a stroke, unfortunately, for El Shabagi. The crowd having no idea what went on there, but for obvious reasons, but he
hand
caught
out.
Him on the downswing. It's a
15
stroke.
15 all.
It's one of your favourite scenarios. You like to give an opponent a bit of a club sometimes, don't you, Flush? I don't know how he's got it that high. No idea.
Yes, lad. 15 all.
That's a little bit of acting by El Shabagi, looking quite dramatic there. It wasn't a winning shot.
No, definitely the right decision there, just a lot.
He's a massive film buff, El Shabagi.
Oh,
read them down the middle shot. Crowd being overzealous with the clapping. Premature.
Out.
Out.
Out. Well, ball was out, all three.
وحيات أمي صح؟
Ball was out. And out. 16-15.
Well, he's absolutely furious there. Translate what he said in Arabic. It was out of court for sure. It did actually go out of court. It's pretty obvious.
16-15.
You know what happened? That's me first. It looks like it's out, but it's not.
Well, he felt that because it kicked onto the side ball, it looked like it had gone over the line, but I think that was over the line there, Flash. What about you with your 20-20 BDIs?
No, my initial reaction just seeing it in real time was it was out.
16-15, game ball.
But it's going to be interesting to see how Rami Ashour responds here, because he really has worked himself up over that decision.
He did. He was howling. Here is heavy movement, it's powerful heavy movement. He's making that floor vibrate.
Yeah.
And he's got it.
17-15.
A brutal
game
win.
El Shabagi. El Shabagi
leads. El Shabagi has played a quite manner.
One game to love.
First game here. Check out this duration, 27 minutes. It's the longest single game we've had so far in this tournament. El Shabagi takes it, 17-15. The younger Egyptian leads by one game to love.
Well, an absolutely titanic start to this World Series final. Rami Ashour started off with the initiative, being extremely positive along that backhand side wall, pushing up the court, looking for the volley, and producing great fertility in the front corner. But Mohamed El Shabagi managed to stay in touch, kept ferreting around behind Ashour, and found a way to produce brilliance to always stay within reach of the older Egyptian. El Shabagi managed to push it to a tiebreak, weathered the storm when Ashour had several game balls, and then played absolutely marvelous to claim this first game.
Well, you can never call that. It was going to be a highly competitive first game, but 27 minutes, that's actually some of the duration of one of the matches that we had in the group stage alone. So El Shabagi's got 94 minutes in his legs from Nick Matthew, and then now a 27-minute brutal first game in his legs. How is he going to keep this going? He's got adrenaline, but how much?
Well, that's the question everyone here at the Westwood Club wants to know, Joey. How much adrenaline does Mohamed El Shabagi have pulsating through his veins? Because that was an absolute ripper of a first game. It'll be extremely interesting to see how he comes out in the second. Does he continue playing at that frantic pace with the very dynamic movement that he did in the first? Or does he try and slow
seconds.
It down, use some height, and try and force Rami into some longer, slower rallies?
Well, Rami Ashour was furious with the ball that went out of court. It was out of court. But whenever Mohamed El Shabagi was down, he produced his best squash, his best outright winner shots. He squeezed on the side ball. He anticipated correctly and attacked savagely into the front of the court, making it mentally very hard for Rami Ashour, who I wouldn't say certainly not squandered because El Shabagi played so brilliantly, but let go. Five or six game ball opportunities, would you say, Flush?
No, absolutely, Joey. And it was a very impressive mental performance from El Shabagi because he really was up against the cosh from Rami Ashour. Rami Ashour was producing some lovely attacking squash, but whenever he was game ball down, El Shabagi produced a brilliant rally and never allowed Ashour to take the game.
You can just see a couple of the crowd wearing beanie hats.
El Shabagi leads. One game to love.
So, so cold.
Love all.
But it isn't cold with these guys. They are generating some ridiculous heat. Go on nitric oxide hit.
Well, the other interesting thing, Joey, is we always talk about Rami Ashour starting slowly and then picking up speed as the match goes on, but he didn't start slowly at all tonight.
No, he didn't. He was brilliant. I mean, he was so patient. He was with it point for point. He had a mini one lead left at one stage. And El Shabagi catching him with that forehand drop. Thought he was able to read it, but not this time.
Exceptional drop from Rami Ashour, staying extremely close to the front wall.
Well, Shabagi's playing that bit more intelligently as well. When he's is slightly under pressure, he's using good height. He got caught there though. That was the wrong shot selection. Looking to try and flick it past Ashour, who was on that tee line. One step for Ashour and then the wrist taking it past El Shabagi. And there's a taxi.
And out to one.
Well, Joey, I think the tactics of El Shabagi have been absolutely brilliant tonight. He's played a substantial bit conservatively straight along the side walls, but he's mixed it very well with brilliant attacking squash and opening the court up.
Out of court, and he's going to appeal it.
Yes, let on the ball on the left wall.
Why? It's the same.
We're getting split decisions here. 2-1 right side.
That was really good one.
2-1, yes, let.
Well, both players feeling an injustice done there. Rami Ashour feeling the ball out, and El Shabagi arguing that it's in. It's obvious. It's going to be interesting how Rami Ashour reacts to those balls along that side wall, because it's definitely in his head after the ball being called out in the first game, and it's an area that's slightly vexing him.
Left side.
Very, very quick reactions there. So El Shabagi building an early lead at 3-1.
Yes, lad. 3-1.
Sure, really trying to push up the pace, but a little bit inaccurate. And if he doesn't find that accuracy, El Shabagi will punish him. Thank you. Yes. And luckily for Daniel Shaw, he hit it hard enough.
Hand out 2-3.
To get away from El Shabagi, but he guessed he was there.
This is very severe hitting from El Shabagi. He's really ripping ashore all over the place with these quick boasts.
Wow. A lot of tricks in that front forehand corner, El Shabagi. Ashore really struggling to read him.
4-2.
He's got the very powerful cross court, he's got the flick, he's got that improvised straight drop shot. There's not many players on the World Tour that Ashore struggles to read, but he's confident in that front right hand corner when El Shabagi is given an opportunity.
Down.
And there's the unforced error.
5-2. Yes, lad. 5-2. El Shabagi, video review on the yes, lad decision.
Well, he's looking for his opponent on this one. It was a loose ball from ashore, but El Shabagi exaggerating his swing a bit here. Let's have a look.
This is an important decision, though, for Rami Ashore to stay in touch with Shabagi.
It is, but he's looking for him with his swing.
I think the question is how far back does the ball come towards ashore?
Well, that's consistent.
Yes, let. Decision upheld. El Shabagi, there's no reviews remaining. 5-2 left side.
From the earlier situation where Rami Ashore felt he had a stroke, he went for a let. So that's consistent, and that's good. The players understanding what they need to do, Flush.
No, absolutely. And I like that decision as well, because it really starts preventing the players from looking for each other and sends the message that they need to be looking to play the ball more consistently.
And out. 3-5.
Needed that point. As you said, it was a scenario where El Shabagi would go 6-2. 4-point lead, but instead it's just a 2-point. Has come
4-5.
And he's held it, and there's no way that any normal human being would be able to flick the ball that close to the sideball. And then Rami Ashore is no normal human being.
5-5.
Far from it, and he's drawn 5-5 as quickly as you can say, Flash Gordon.
I think this is the area of the match where El Shabagi needs to keep the energy levels high, because he's getting a lot of squash in his legs now.
Hand out, 6-5.
Again, it's that front forehand corner. He can't read him, he's not reading him.
Yes, let. 6-5. Thank you. round out.
Well, a lovely hold round the middle from Rami Ashour, and forcing El Shorbagi to take the long way round. So Rami Ashour starting to assert a little bit of dominance here. He's looking more confident.
Court attendant, please.
El Shorbagi is very, very good at timing his court attendance situations when he needs a breather. And there's the Egyptian actually looking, which you'd expect, feeling it, because the squash he produced in that first game, the duration, I mean, 27 minutes.
7-6.
No, again, on this court, Blush, we've said how cold it is, and it is brutal.
No, it's amazing the level of intensity and duration of rallies these players are managing to produce on a court that this cold and dead.
Wow. He took that very early, slightly off the join, but to see the way he lingers and then steps into
8-6.
Clever use of his timing of the shot there. That was what caught El Shorbagi by surprise.
Out.
Good hitting, quality hitting. El Shorbagi calling his ball out of court. I think Ashour a bit furious that the referees didn't spot it as quickly as El Shorbagi.
El Shorbagi's starting to look a little bit weary here. He's going to need to have a big push somewhere to try and nullify these attacks of Ashour.
There it is. There's a killer blow. El Shorbagi pointing to his partner's head there.
10-6. Too good. Game ball.
Four game balls to equalize for Ashour.
Down. And out. 7-10. Game ball.
Marvelous get there from Ashour, completely opening the racket face up to lift the ball high on the front wall.
This is ridiculous. Again. Oh. You certainly have to work for that point. El Shorbagi was playing very dynamically at the end, even that last
11-7. Game to Ashour. Games are 1-1.
John Mazzarella getting very excited there. 13 minutes, second game. Ashour takes it 11-7. It's one game all.
Well, Mohamed El Shorbagi came racing out of the blocks there at the start of the second game, running away to a 5-2 lead. He seemed inspired and had all the answers. But in the middle stage of the game, El Shorbagi's movement seemed to tire, and Rami Ashour took full advantage, springing up the court, firing balls into the front corners, and being very positive in his shot selection. Eventually, El Shorbagi did more and more work and ran out of steam near the end, and Rami Ashour levels at one game apiece.
Well, Flash, Mohamed El Shorbagi off to winning that first game and leading 5-2 in the second. Ashour had to turn it on. He had to respond to that. That was a good situation there for El Shorbagi, but you never know with Rami Ashour. Even a three-point lead in the mid-stage is nowhere near enough. But El Shorbagi sparked up a little bit towards the end there again. So he'll regroup. Again, he must have adrenaline on tap somewhere, because I've never seen El Shorbagi fly around the court like he's doing in this tournament.
No, absolutely. And I think the real question at this point, Joey, is how does El Shorbagi's body respond to the pounding that Rami Ashour is delivering? because Rami Ashour is really prolonging the rallies and systematically moving Elshour Baghi to all four corners of the court, putting tremendous amounts of lactic acid in those legs.
Well, Ashour keeping on his toes there, just walking around, looking pretty fresh. I mean, he's one of these players that disappears. He doesn't like to sit down particularly in between games. And Elshour Baghi making sure he takes his whole 2 minutes. He'll be taking energy gels and all sorts. But tactically, what do you think Elshour Baghi needs to do? He's having a very deep think there as we see him at courtside. He looks a bit more subdued now, Elshour Baghi, after Ashour taking that second game. Just the mannerisms of the younger Egyptian. Looking a little bit more insular, if that's the correct word.
Well, I think Elshour Baghi felt he was starting to run away with that second game when he got to 5-2
time.
Up. And then he slowly ran out of steam physically, and I think he's frustrated that mentally he had a bit of a lapse and had a few loose balls that allowed Rami Ashour to deliver pressure on him and get him to that fatigue level. I think at this point, from a tactical point of view, Elshour Baghi needs to generally slow the pace down, hit a very high quality of length, and force Ashour deeper into the court. And then when he gets loose balls, attack with a lot of speed and a lot of venom, and put as much pressure on Ashour as he can in very quick bursts.
Games are 1-1. Ashour serving. Thank you. Love all.
Well, that's the first. The referee having to quieten down the crowd here.
Well, that's a marvelous start from Rami Ashour.
One love.
Right up on the top of the tee. Great rapid control.
Down. Too low. Down and out. 1-2.
Point for Elshour Baghi to draw lever at 2-2.
2-2.
Rallies will get shorter now that this ball's softened. And it will make that first hit even more important. You see, struggling to get it to the back of the court. It's not hitting the back wall. It's to be very hard. Oh, that's a great shot. Elshour Baghi a bit of a taste of his own medicine, improvising in that front right hand corner, which has been a tough area for Rami Ashour. Not read Elshour Baghi consistently at all in that area. And that is just bread and butter.
4-2.
Poking it into that front left hand corner. So points coming quickly, Flag.
They certainly are. This is the area where Elshour Baghi needs to buckle down and not let Rami Ashour start running away with it. He's physically tired, he's mentally tired after a very difficult campaign here at the World Series Finals.
5-2.
And Ashour is inspired. I mean, we heard in his interview last night just how much this title means to him. And he's playing with great intensity and he's still relatively fresh.
That was a poor width from Ashour. Manages to get an on-course there. You see there, right onto his racket. Comfortable for Elshour Baghi. Well, he's buzzing round the court now. Ashour. El Shabagi certainly feeling the effects of
7-2.
The first game and also the marathon last night. And when we talk about a marathon, it was an hour and a half, but an hour and a half of multiple sprints. So I can imagine that. Not plodding along, that's for sure.
Stroke to El Shabagi. And out. 3-7. Down. And out. 8-3.
Mohamed El Shabagi's movement into that front corner becoming very labored. Rami Ashour is certainly sensing blood here and he's pushing up the court, but slightly cheap error there from Ashour.
Yeah, he's made a
hand out 4-9.
Even with El Shabagi in this physical state, he could not give away those unforced errors.
Down.
And there's one from
hand out. 10-4, game ball.
He looks slightly ashen grey there. This is to be expected.
Down. Game to Ashour, 11-4. And Ashour leads 2-1.
The ball was called down originally, but it's certainly up from Rami Ashour. He closes out a very quick third game in 5 minutes, 11-4. Ashour now leads 2-1.
Well, the long duration of time on court in the previous rounds from Mohamed El Shabagi starting to catch up with him, and he comes out in this third game very flat. Rami Ashour senses it extremely early and went straight for the jugular, attacking it well and being exceedingly positive to take the commanding lead in this final.
Well, it's not surprising that Mohamed El Shabagi is starting to run out of juice, Flash Gordon. 27 minutes against Rami Ashour. Most players can't even last that long in a full match, let alone one game. And, I mean, he's got 2 minutes to recover. He's not going to recover. The resources are now depleted. He'll be using glycogen from his liver after the muscles have gone. You can see the body language, the facial expressions, also the colour in his face. He's gone kind of ashen grey. He's on shutdown now. And Ashour just doing that rocking we saw him do in the Swedish Open on his hips, just trying to keep himself going, the legs, the players desperate to keep the body nice and warm in between games here. Unfortunately for the El Shabagi fans, he's gone on court first to try and make a bit of a statement that he's okay physically, but he'll still hit some shots, I'm sure of it. He'll still put some outright winners in, and if there's a couple of unforced errors from Ashour, El Shabagi might be able to slightly rekindle the adrenaline, but I just feel that El Shabagi is now really on the ropes, and it is down to Rami Ashour to finish him.
No, I totally concur with you, Joey. I think here at the start of the fourth, we're going to see a quite rapid start from El Shabagi, an almost last-ditch effort to try and get back into it. But for Rami Ashour, as long as he's able to hold the fort down and
seconds.
Play with sensible straight lines and good width, I think he's going to prove a little bit too fresh for the younger Egyptian.
Ashour Ashur leads. Ashur leads.
Oh, well, we know Ashur leads.
Microphone, please. Yeah, okay. Yeah. Ashur leads 2-1. Level. Down.
Well, slightly and ambitious down. There from Rami Ashur. Right, no,
even from him, it was slightly ambitious. Trying to refocus himself. Right cross court nick off the tightest ball around. Well, that is a gut-ripping boast.
Well, I think those boasts from Rami Ashur paying great dividends, really putting tremendous work in El Shrabagi's legs.
Oh, this is brilliant from El Shrabagi. He's going
to get sure video review
does
on the
like
leg,
to video review in the very first couple of rallies. He's got to be one of the worst video reviewers, actually, Rami Ashur.
Well, it certainly is an interesting time to review.
Well, I think that is a let, though. I think that is a let. What do you think?
No,
Flash?
No, no.
You're really staring at the screen. I can barely see it myself because you're that far in front.
Well, from that angle, it certainly looks like a simple let on that bird's eye view. Yeah, I'd go let here.
How far short did it fall? And his momentum's going forward. El Shabagi's moved into his line. That's a good
yes,
decision.
Let. Decision overruled. Ashur has one review remaining.
So,
one
well, maybe
right
Rami Ashur is slightly better at the reviewing side of things than you gave him credit for, Joey.
Yeah, that's for sure. Wow. Good use of height.
Too long.
Trying to play short, sharp rallies, so a tactical change from the younger Egyptian. That serves straight on the racket.
Hand out.
Well, it's clever play from Ashur, sensing how dead the ball goes in between games and taking full advantage with the quick volley drop.
Well, the guy's just having a bit of a play. He did actually hit El Shabagi on the head, so he'll want to give that ball a bit of a wide.
Tight play from Ashur along the backhand side wall.
2-2.
Really squeezing El Shabagi.
Too much of an angle, too much time. Threatening the drive,
3-2.
Softening the hands.
Down. 4-2.
Well, El Shabagi certainly can't afford to have too many more errors. With his physical condition and the motivation of Rami Ashur, it's a cocktail that really isn't going to work out for him.
Down.
El Shabagi
5-2.
Tried to press very hard in the early stage. He'll keep going, but Ashur with a massive momentum in this ball.
There from Rami Ashur.
6-2.
Falling rapidly round the middle. We see the lovely wrist work from the young, for the older Egyptian.
Hand out 3-6. 4-6.
Well, and just when it looked like Remy Ashour was starting to run away with his fourth game, two errors creep in and allows Mohamed El Shorabagi a bit of a lifeline here. Straight drive from Remy Ashour. Lovely weight of shot. Second bounce, almost in the back wall, Nick.
So Ashour revving it up in the back stage of this, back end of this fourth game.
Ouch.
And there's the unforced error.
Take your time.
No,
take your time. Take your time, man.
Remy Ashour really in a rush to get the proceedings on, where we see him leaving the court in hunt of the ball.
Hand out.
What?
No let. Hand out, 5-8.
El Shorabagi passed his boundaries, and you really must feel, Joey, that the writing is on the wall now.
Well, it's only 2 points away, really, but I just think Ashour is far too good a player to even let the fighting spirit of El Shorabagi come back into this.
Down.
And there is the unforced error that presents Remy Ashour with
10-5
championship balls.
Match ball. Down.
And there it
11-5.
Is.
11-5. Game and match to Ashour. 3-1. 15-17. 11-7. 11-4. 11-5.
It's a very, very impressive squash. Well, let's see it. A quick interview. When the MC, Gilly Lane, manages to get courtside past all the crowd. I'm sure this will be 100-mile-an-hour interview. Ashour thoroughly deserving that final. Mohamed El Shorabagi, what a performance, really, when you think about the massive semi-final.
What a final that was. Remy Ashour. Our Power Courts 2013 PSA World Series Finals champion.
Thank you very much. It's been a long day, actually. I felt that this day has, you know, lasted longer than the week we've been here for. That was probably a tough match. It was a very tough match. Me and Mohamed is, he's 23. There's not that much big difference in age, but I mean, I think every month in this game makes a difference and adds an experience and makes you a different person. Every tournament makes you a different person. Every injury makes you a different person. So I think he's got a lot ahead of him. And yeah, I think and I hope we can play a lot of more finals together, because I think we do play some quality squash. I believe so. And yeah, it's And I was just, I was really proud today, you know. Just two Egyptians in the first time in the history of squash to play in the World Series Finals, you know, final. That's something I'm proud of. Something good for our country as well. Yeah, I mean, we need those kind of motivations these days, especially back home. Things would uplift the people a lot. So, yeah, we're trying to do our role and do our best around the world and raise the flag as much as we can. Other than that, yeah, I think, what do you think about the game today?
I think it's more what you think, not that what I think. But four wins in 2013 in World Series events, to add this to your long list of accomplishments, what does that mean?
Wow, I think it's kind of a comeback for me. I'm great. I made it today. I'm grateful for a lot of people. I would have never done it with a lot of people on my side. A lot of people have been helping me. Oh, well, I mean, it's a very, very big list. I hope I don't bore you guys, but I gotta say it at least a few of them. I mean, first of all, of course, I'm grateful for the Lord. Second, my mom, my dad, my parents. You know, I'll never give them back even half what they've always been giving me. And they're great, and thank you very much for everything you're doing for me. My kids in my academy back home, Inspire Squash Academy, this win is for you guys, and I'm glad I'm back. You've always been, you know, standing, supporting me. A lot of people, of course. I've been working with Terry Linko, squash legend. Everyone knows him, and his fitness coach for a while now. He's getting me physically in the right position, so I'm really grateful for you. He's a great guy, and I'm really happy to be associated with him. A lot of people back home, my academy manager, Tariq Shamikh, a lot of people have been helping me, my brother, of course, a lot of people have been always supporting me, everyone on the social media as well, Twitter and Facebook, everyone, these guys are amazing, and and yeah, I just want to say as well, finally, I just want to say I'm very happy to be here. Again, it's always a pleasure being in Virginia. I love this cozy town. I feel really home. I feel warm. Gus, you do a great job, man. Seriously, you always take care, get good, very good care of us. The sponsors, everyone. This could have never been possible without you. Dave as well. You do an amazing job. PSA, Joey, and Chris, everyone, the commentator, Gilly Lane. Thank you, guys, and hopefully we'll be back soon next year. Thank you.
Gonna take a short, quick break.
Last thing. This final, Rami Ashour maintaining his higher seeding, getting past very, very dangerous Mohamed El Shabagi. 15-17, 11-7, 11-4, 11-5. 3-1 in 63 minutes.
Well, Mohamed El Shabagi coming out very, very physically jaded there in the fourth game. But Rami Ashour was motivated and took full advantage. He played clever squash, worked El Shabagi around the court using all four corners. He pushed up the court and volleyed with tremendous accuracy. And eventually, he just had too much for Mohamed El Shabagi. A brilliant event for the young Egyptian Mohamed El Shabagi, but just a bridge too far today. And Rami Ashour, the champion of the World Series Finals,